SIT is a creation of Supreme Court order. If you can share the list with SIT, there was no reason why you shouldn't have shared the list with the Supreme Court.
The knuckles of Congress as to why they were not forming the SIT. It was only when we formed the SIT,
it would serve you better if you consult your lawyers who were representing the government. The Supreme Court made it clear that you have to give the list in 24 hours' time. This is the kind of strong language that the Supreme Court used, that don't try to protect anybody and furnish the list within 24
hours.
And maybe, you are better aware,
because we were committed to the cause of black money, which others were not.
Maybe
and today you appear to be frustrated only
not.
Because of the fact that
but,
your
but
friend's
you are
name
doing
would
no
be exposed.
To the nation
Congress would stand
by
exposed.
Not.
Can I come in? Can I come back to the debate?
And revealing the
can I come back to the debate? Gentlemen, thank you very much. Thank you very much. No, one second. I want to come back to the debate. I believe, like many ordinary Indians, that perception is important. Morals are compulsory and values should still remain.
Yes.
Now, Mr. Patra, don't react. But you just did not refuse support from a man called Sharad Pawar, who, along with his nephew Ajit Pawar, you used to accuse of masterminding a 70,000 crore irrigation scam. Now, your position was different before the election.
No,
1 minute, don't teach me real politics. Second point. 70,000 crore irrigation. So many people committed suicide. Farmers committed suicide, right? Now you take outside support from that man. Now, you didn't say we don't need your support.
No, please
go away. One second. So you use him as a guarantor against the Shiv Sena. Secondly, you don't reveal the names in the black money list. Right? Thirdly, you use all kinds of legal arguments to not reveal the names in the black money list. I want to now expose and break one of your arguments. With your permission, Mr. Patra, please listen carefully. Prasenjit. Prasenjit can come in at this point. I lost you in between. The affidavit the government submitted in the Supreme Court yesterday states that the chairman and vice chairman of the SIT had been briefed of the cases in detail on August 5th. In other words, the briefing of the SIT chairman was done in detail on August 5th. Yeah, check your facts. It's right there. Maybe at top of that page. Now, what people want to know, Prasenjit, is if the SIT and chairman and vice chairman have been briefed in detail, which means already you've done some substantial work on the cases, why are you telling the court we've done no work, we can't tell you the names, we have no details? Both things cannot be right, no? Prasenjit? Both things cannot be right. One second.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, absolutely. See, I have a completely different suspicion. I think that the reason why the Supreme Court today came out so strongly against the government is because there is some foul play going on. And the Supreme Court has, you know, smelt some foul play. That is why it is forcing the government. It is forcing the government's hands today that please submit this to the Supreme Court.
Now, wait.
I want to ask a simple question. I want to ask a simple question to Mr. Sambit Patra.
Go ahead.
Let him
go
answer.
Yeah, yeah.
Can he guarantee?
Yeah.
Can he guarantee that no BJP leader's name appears in that list? Can he guarantee?
I can guarantee that no BJP person's name is there in that list. I'm already accepting. I can guarantee no BJP person's name will appear on the list because that is the faith I hold for my leadership. That is the faith that I hold for my party. Let Congress also guarantee the same thing that they hold, that no congressman's name would appear. I guarantee on Times Not Today
that
no BJP person's name would appear on this list.
No, what do you mean by BJP? Are you sure it is not there? Have you seen the list? Have you seen the list?
I have not seen the list, but I have told. I have that faith for my party's integrity. I am the soldier of the party about whose faith, whose integrity I have utmost faith. But Mr. Chidambaram did not have the faith.
Sambit!
Mr. Chidambaram was asked day before yesterday or 2 days ago.
Sambit!
See the list. Mr. Chidambaram said he did not feel the importance of seeing the list in spite of the fact that he was a finance minister.
You cannot be on the black money list.
Why did Mr. Chidambaram, in spite of the fact that he was a finance your minister finance of the country, did not wish to go through the list?
Selectively,
that means he has gone through the list, and there is something in the list which Mr. Chidambaram did not wish to reveal.
Slap your government down. You people should be ashamed.
No, no, Mr. Chidambaram.
So, Mr. Chidambaram, who was a finance minister,
you see, Mr. Patra, Mr. Patra, Mr. Patra, 1 minute, Mahesh Jethmalani coming in on the debate, please. One second. Mr. Jethmalani, Mr. Jethmalani, this is a serious setback for the BJP. I have several reasons. One is because the government's intent has been questioned in the Supreme Court, saying, why are you providing a protective umbrella? Secondly, the black money list is being monitored by the Supreme Court. The government has no control over it anymore, right? Thirdly, the power to launch prosecution, since it lies with the center, the Supreme Court monitoring of this list is going to eliminate the discretion of the government of excluding the names or being selective. And fourthly, because the government sought to modify the 2011 order of the Supreme Court, they slammed the UPA government for doing the same thing, and they welcomed the Supreme Court order of July 4, 2011. Now they were trying to do the same thing, weren't they, Mr. Jethmalani?
But, you know, this was a Arnav, this was a complete legal misadventure. I don't know what triggered it off, because frankly speaking, the Supreme Court, both in the original judgment and in the judgment which dismissed the review of the UPA, in both those judgments, it had entrusted the exclusive investigation of all these account holders' monies to the SIT monitored by the Supreme Court. Therefore, I don't know where the government has any discretion in the matter, what they were trying to do. Everything, I mean, even after today, the government would be well advised to withdraw their application and say, you are in charge of this investigation, you didn't trust the UPA, that's why you gave it to the SIT, let the SIT do its job. And incidentally, even concluded investigations, and I'm told that the UPA government gave amnesty to 100 people, mainly in the French list. Even that can be reopened, because as per the judgment of the Supreme Court of 2011, reiterated in 2014, the SIT can reopen any investigation, concluded or not, and satisfy itself about the bona fides of the conclusion reached by the government. The best course for this government is to withdraw this application tomorrow.
No, whatever. I don't care about the legal process anymore. The big question is what? Big question is they made tall claims. All kinds of tall claims during the election campaign. Gaurav Bhatia, I see your hand go up. Let's go to the big
direction.
Screen. 1 second.
We are working in the direction of
Gaurav Bhatia.
Today, the intentions of the BJP government are under scanner. Whether they are genuine or not, why were they not assisting the Supreme Court? And let me say this, if Sambit Patra is saying this with conviction that there is no name of a BJP leader, some minister has violated the oath of secrecy. Because Mr. Sambit Patra is not supposed to know the content which only the minister dealing with the subject is supposed to know. So, Mr. Sambit Patra, I don't know how you are aware that there is no name of the BJP leader.
I go to now M.R. Venkatesh. M.R. Venkatesh. M.R. Venkatesh. Before Sambit Patra, M.R. Venkatesh.
I know.
Arnab.
M.R. Venkatesh.
Now, the most important question which will stare at us in the next few weeks will be that the SIT got the names on 27th June. Today is 4 months since the SIT got the names. Now, what did the SIT do with the names? That is also a very important question. Let us not forget the SIT has the names for the last 120 days. And what did it do? It did not inform the parent body, namely right. The Supreme Court, that it has got the names in a sealed envelope from the government. And this is going ridiculous. See, let us understand, the SIT is nothing but 11 officers of the government of India, the CBDT, the CBI, the IB, the RAW, all of them, who individually were failures, have been collectivized under a garb called the SIT, and we want success out of the SIT. This is going to be another big question that is staring at us. Will the SIT ever deliver? Yes, the names are with it. Yes, it has got all the powers. It has been fathered by the Supreme Court. Yes, no doubt about it. But what will happen after that? What is it going to deliver?
There was a dramatic, very relevant question. There was a dramatic press conference, first cabinet meeting of Mr. Modi. Super fast government press conference. Ravi Shankar Prasad says, in our first cabinet meeting, we announce an SIT. Almost as if it was a gift to the nation from the new NDA government. Whereas the fact was, the SIT was formed under compulsive orders of the Supreme Court. You didn't have an option. I mean, if today M.R. Venkatesh would have been Prime Minister of India, even he would have had to order an SIT. Even Gaurav Bhatia would have had to order an SIT. Sambit Patra, it is not an invention of the NDA government. First, make that admission on the program, because too many times you take credit. We set up an SIT.
As I
mean, what do you mean we set up an SIT?
Since 2000,
what do you mean we set up an SIT?
Supreme Court has.
What do you mean we set up an SIT?
The Supreme Court set up the SIT.
Why it was not forming an SIT?
You didn't set up an SIT.
Previous dispensation.
M.R. Venkatesh.
Who set up the SIT?
M.R. Venkatesh. M.R. Venkatesh. M.R. Venkatesh. M.R. Venkatesh. 1 minute. M.R. Venkatesh.
Please,
Mr. Venkatesh.
No,
see, now, Sambit,
Mr. Venkatesh, Sambit, please, you've been proven wrong, Sambit, M.R. Venkatesh.
For you. Please understand. Now, the important question is, there is a man called Hasan Ali, whose investigation is now no more in the hands of the government. It is in the hands of the SIT. The SIT was formed 150 days ago. If the Modi government did not do anything for the last 150 days, the SIT did not do anything for the last 149 days. Now, it's the time for the Supreme Court also to ask the SIT, please let me show your progress report. Why is it that the Hasan Ali case has not progressed? Why is it the PN notes have not been addressed properly? Whether the loopholes in the SEBI guidelines have not been addressed properly? What has happened to the French list? What has happened to the German list? All these questions have to be asked to the SIT also.
Are you doubting the credibility of the SIT? Come on.
I am not doubting. I am only saying there are nothing to show that the SIT has actually delivered.
Under the auspices of Supreme Court of India. So I believe we should not, and in any way, questioning the Supreme Court of India's
intentions. We are not questioning. No, see, we are not questioning the intentions. We are questioning the output.
Don't use that argument.
No, this is not an argument that
is there any kind of contention that the SIT
democracy,
is
nobody
the
is above
Court
anybody. Nobody is above anybody. We have a right to question everybody.
So now, Ashish Khetan.
Why we are all dismayed today is because this government has shown no moral courage or guts, which was expected of this government. Because bringing back black money, revealing all the names, bringing credibility to the probe, was one of their tallest promise during the election campaign. When Arun Jaitley sings in the same tune as Mr. Chidambaram and Pranav Mukherjee used to sing during UPA, then what does it show? It leads to betrayal of public trust. Arun Jaitley used the argument which was punctured by the Supreme Court in its judgment in year 2011. Supreme Court had said that we have perused the double taxation avoidance treaty and
after
we find nothing
the hopes of
in the
people
agreement
of
which
Delhi,
proscribes the government
Mr.
from revealing
Khetan,
the name.
You should not be speaking that anyone is puncturing anything.
That's the biggest
you
problem
all
with
the
government.
Of the fact that we
have
had
Summit,
that
please.
Betrayed right from 2009,
people's mandate and
we are the ones who are
the public
going to bring
trust.
It to a conclusive
now,
end.
What is the problem today that every second day they are doing a flip-flop? In a TV interview they say one thing, before Supreme Court they say yet another thing. And they come and they send somebody like Sambit Patra, you know, who just for the lack of a better phrase, I would say just shoots the breeze and thinks that, you know, just by muddying the waters,
Khetan,
the issue will get blown away.
I have not been questioning about your singing career
that you had. So what I'm saying is that,
so better
show
not
some
be
guts,
personal, Mr. Khetan.
Show moral courage.
Career. We all are aware of
show
that.
Moral
so
courage.
Please don't
show some
personal,
guts.
Or else I can
show
also
intent
expose you over here on the channel.
And
so better
do not
don't be
betray the,
and start
the faith that
about
people
the
have reposed
of the
in
Aam Aadmi Party.
Do not betray the faith that people have put in you when they voted for you. So don't do that.
No, what
because
did
I'll
you
tell
do then
you
to Delhi? What did you do then to Delhi
the
when you ran away to become the Prime Minister and became Jamanat Chapati thereafter? You were respecting the people of this country.
UBS
you were respecting the
bank
of the people
was forced
of Delhi.
To give to the
you
U.S. government.
To become the
and
Prime
you know
Minister
why?
Of this country.
Because
you are
U.S. government crashed the whip.
Betray the people.
What we want from you is to crack the whip. Crack the whip on all
don't
the black
worry.
Money holders
don't
in the country and abroad. Crack the whip on all the hawala operators. Crack the whip on those banks who are running a money laundering racket in India.
We
why are you not
party.
Cracking the
we
whip? You have agencies
party.
With you.
We are not,
you have all the powers with you. You are not
a guerrilla politician
you are not
party.
Even,
remember that.
You don't even
we
have
do
the baggage
ways
of the coalition government.
We have a very open way of functioning.
You have a clean
I
mandate.
Absolutely
what
clear.
Is stopping you? You cannot even make the excuse of a DMK. You cannot even make the excuse of a Raja or a
nothing
or
is stopping
Dimaran.
Us.
You
the
have
only
a clean
reason
mandate.
Is you should do your homework completely.
I have done
we
my homework.
We had submitted the names
and
to
after
the SIT.
Having
you
done
should
my
have
homework,
gone through the
I'm
affidavit
making these
that
remarks.
The government had submitted.
That you are betraying the people of this country.
Before shouting on news channels, you should have seen the affidavit.
See, Sambit,
I have
seen Sambit.
15 names.
And I have
you
seen
come
the interview given by Mr.
Sambit, Sambit, I'll tell you the various places. 1 minute. Just a minute. Nobody forced you. Nobody, Sambit Patra, forced you to make black money issue a political debate. I'm making this point since the last 1 week. One is technical argument, which Mr. Jaitley is saying, double taxation agreement, I can't go reveal it for so-and-so reason. That, leave that aside. My point is Mohandas Pai. And let Mohandas Pai come in. I find tonight that just because some people are not politicians, they are being edged out. And since Ashish Khaitan became a politician, he's edged out everyone else. And since Mahesh Jethmalani, most very interestingly, is keeping he's on a self-imposed exile from politics. He's also edged out himself, on his own, because maybe he doesn't want to commit himself. But what we want to know is, tell me, Mahesh Jethmalani, let me start with you. No, don't be so forgiving today. I mean, you're being extremely forgiving on a subject I thought you were passionate about. Who forced the BJP to make it an election issue? To pass a political resolution in a National Council meeting? To pass a political resolution in the National Council meeting in August, in January? To pass a resolution saying we'll reveal the names in its economic resolution in Ramlila grounds? For Rajnath Singh to make it the subject of a presidential speech at Ramlila grounds? For the Deputy Prime Minister Lal Krishna Advani to say we will bring back every single naya paisa back to this country, to have a Jan Chetna Yatra on this subject, to unleash the political impact of Baba Ramdev nation to nation, village to village, city to city on this subject? Who forced the BJP to make those commitments to the people of India? Who did? Just because it was good political masala? Mahesh Jethmalani before the elections? To throw at the people, to spice things up a bit?
The latest action belies those promises, and that's all one can say. I mean,
no, but who forced the BJP to make these tall claims?
It's a betrayal of your... nobody forced them. I think they were genuine in their intent.
No, genuine in intent? No, how can you be genuine in intent and poor in follow-up? No, 1 second.
But you maybe because...
Why are you pulling back today? Why are you being careful in what you say? You're holding yourself back.
Why am I being careful? I said, because I don't want to attribute any motives over just one legal misadventure. I mean, I can't attribute motives.
Legal misadventure? What about the political part of it, Mahesh Jethmalani? Come on. Who made?
Of course, this government.
Who squeezed the issue politically?
I said unambiguously that this government should have honored its electoral promise made repeatedly during elections.
Did
that they will reveal the names. Go to the Supreme Court and look for an excuse to get out of your electoral promise. You reveal the names when you've got them. There is no bar on you, and your DTAA argument is a complete legal non-starter.
The point is that
Prasenjit,
in their promise, they have already failed. Now the Supreme Court is forcing them. So once the Supreme Court has stepped in, now the BJP's game is over. So they have already failed their promise that they had made. That is a point to be noted.
Precisely.
Now they will be forced to do it.
Who forced the BJP? Who forced the BJP to make these tall claims? Who did Mohandas Pai? Most of this issue is about the hype. Most of this issue is about the hype. You create the hype, you can't complain about the hype.
Absolutely, Arnab, because the DTA clauses were the same 4 years back that they are now. DTA agreement has not changed. The BJP should have known that the DTA had made a particular statement, and now they cannot take shelter under the DTA after coming to power to say the DTA requires investigation, secrecy, etc. They knew about it all along. So what is the big deal? They should make it public. They cannot take shelter under DTA. They have no leg to stand on today. And I think they messed up the whole issue. They should have taken the bull by the horns and given the list.
Salman,
can I come in to make an important point over here?
Yes, I think, Sambit, you want to make an important point. Yes, what is the point you want to make?
They signed 17 of these agreements.
No, 1 second.
Arnab, the issue,
so do they not
the
know what these agreements are about?
Can I? I've been listening to everyone. Can I just make an important point? The government had asked for a clarification, two-point clarification. First about DTAA and second about the privacy clause. The Supreme Court gave a clarification that, well, yes, don't
Supreme
hold to the DTA, give us the names, which the government had already done to the SIT.
Had punctured
and
the
second
same
point,
legal argument, which then the,
who is
the
shouting
then,
again
the
again?
Then UPA government
when
was proposing.
Who is this?
Supreme
who is,
Court
who is
had said there is
again,
nothing
again,
under DTA.
Please,
there is nothing
is
under double taxation avoidance
I'm forced
treaty.
To call him an anarchist now.
The government
I'm forced to call him an anarchist now. Because when I am keeping
way
my point of view in legal term,
Supreme Court
anarchism should not be allowed.
This argument.
had negated this argument. That's why I'm saying it is a political dishonesty and double speak of the worst kind.
No, one second.
Mr. Arun Jaitley does not
know. 1 minute. Well, just a minute. No, I'll say 1 minute. 1 minute. 1 minute. 1 minute. 1 minute, please. 1 minute.
Or no.
1 minute. No, 1 minute, please. 1 minute. 1 minute, please. Calm down. I got your point. I know you've been briefed. I don't. I will not ask you who briefed you. Just 1 minute. Just 1 minute. But a point is made. Same attempt was made in 2011.
Absolutely.
Every 3 years. So now you'll say 2017. We'll seek the same clarification. You see, what has the Supreme Court said? The Supreme Court says, please hear this. Please hear this. Your argument is just about to be completely torn apart. What the Supreme Court says is the new regime at the center. Please, the Supreme Court doesn't change its logic depending on Congress and BJP at power. It says the new regime at the center. It says the new regime at the center cannot ask for the modification of an order when it was passed in an open court and accepted by the government. Yes. You do not do anything. Just pass on information of account holders to us and we will pass order for further probe. You understand? It's as simple as that.
I understand. Let me complete.
Then what is the point you're making?
Wanted to submit.
The new law.
The point that I was making was the point that I was making was the government had requested for confidentiality.
You should be ashamed because you have been censured.
But it should not be made public. We want the confidentiality clause.
Don't you understand what the Supreme Court is trying to say?
The government sources does not become dry.
We are
in the Supreme Court is censuring the government. You should be ashamed.
The Chief Justice of India says. 1 second, the government tells the Supreme Court how if all genuine account holders are disclosed, it will interfere with privacy. 1 minute, 1 minute. What the Supreme Court says, you don't do anything, we will do everything, you just give us the names you got from the foreign banks, we will not change even a word of our order.
Yes.
That's... Arnab, that's what I was saying.
No, when but it's not what you were saying.
Had given a list of 26 names to the Supreme
yes.
Court.
And when they were
that is what the Chief Justice of
the Supreme
Milani
Court said,
made
not
public.
You.
Germany
now,
had written a letter.
Why aren't you understanding the point?
And today, this government only wants confidentiality of the names.
Are so the government, the government, government, lashes, Supreme Court lashes out at the government on its ambitious plans of modifying a Supreme Court order. In black money, government gets a whipping in the top court of the country. That's the news.
No, Arnab, it is wrong to say that the government gets a whipping. Remember one thing, Supreme
and you,
Court
and you should apologize.
An order
the BJP should apologize to the country. Your friend, when you failed in a crucial election promise,
all the government
you failed.
What is the Congress saying?
It means that
what
the
is
new
the,
chunk that
I have one last question for Congress. My last question is for the Congress. My last question is for the Congress. Am I allowed, please?
One question, Arnab. I want to ask you a question.
Who's asking?
I want to ask you a question.
Yeah, you...
Why didn't you ask the BJP one simple question that you asked me? I'm asking you a question. Why didn't you ask the BJP this question when you talked about those 100 people who got amnesty? That in their 23-point plan that the BJP said they were going to implement in 2011...
No, but who are the 100 names you... Who are the 100 people you protected?
And amnesty.
No, but who are the 100 people you protected? Who are the 100 people you protected? Who are the 100 people you protected?
The government of India can give you those names. The BJP should answer...
Are there any Congress leaders on that list?
The BJP should answer whether they have been stand by the 23-point plan.
I want to remind you... I want to remind you, Sambit Patra...
Ask the government of India.
Sambit Patra, government of India or the Congress government of India? You want me to go to Manmohan Singh? You are saying ask Manmohan Singh? You are saying ask Manmohan Singh?
These 100 people under the belt.
You are saying ask Manmohan Singh who we protected?
You have not taken action against one single person.
Who are the 100 people you protected?
One rupee has come to India.
Who are the 100 people you protected?
15 lakh rupees you have brought zilch.
And why was not Mr. Chidambaram going through the list? Or had he gone through the list and seen certain names which he did not want to disclose?
All right. Any problem with that? The government of India...
I just as I wrap up tonight, I want to remind Mr. Salman Sos. M.R. Venkatesh is the last word. M.R. Venkatesh.
Whatever be it, it will be a very, 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 very long night for both the corporate and the political world in India today. It's going to be a long night. People will not go to sleep, even if they have a couple of compos or whatever tablets they take. It's going to be absolute, pell-mell out there.
They have already started.
And when the names, and I want to repeat one thing I said earlier, M.R. Venkatesh, when the names come out, which they will, hopefully, eventually, whenever they do, the Congress won't get credit. the BJP won't get credit. The Supreme Court of India will get a lot of credit. Thank you for joining me on debate number one on the News Hour tonight.